So we'll just revise complex numbers a bit. We'll familiarize ourselves with the results, and then we'll get on with our quest for defining logarithms for negative and complex numbers. Now, complex numbers started when Euler defined a quantity iota, and he defined it as iota square equals minus 1. And then we came up all sorts of numbers, which are of the form z equals x plus iota y, where x and y, they are real numbers. Now, he called this x as real part and this y as imaginary part. So say, for example, suppose I have a complex number which is defined as under root 3 and plus iota. So in this case, real part of complex number is under root 3 and its imaginary part is coefficient of iota, which is 1. So this is how we can write any general complex number as x plus iota y. Now, we can express any complex number in polar form also, but before that, we need to understand how to express a complex number on arcane plane. So just like we represent points on Cartesian plane, in the same way, we can represent complex numbers on arcane plane. So in arcane plane, again, we have two axes. Now we call them real axis and imaginary axis. And any point z, which is x plus iota y, is expressed as this coordinate x comma y. So any point z, which is x plus iota y, it is this distance x and this distance y. Now, for this complex number z, we'll define two things. First, its modulus. And modulus is defined as mod of z, and we also call it r, and it is nothing but it is distance of this point from origin. Now, we know that this value is x and this value is y. So this distance, which is r, we can say this r is under root of x square plus y square. So if for any complex number, we have to find its modulus, I'll just need to take a square root of some of the squares of their real part and imaginary part. Now say for this case, if I have to find mod of z, then it will be under root of under root 3 square plus imaginary part square, which is 1 square. So it will be 3 plus 1, which is 2. So modulus for this complex number is 2. Now another thing that we will define for this complex number is the angle it makes with positive real axis. Now the angle that any complex number makes with positive real axis, or this line makes with positive real axis, is called as its argument. So generally written as argz, or maybe I write this as theta, and it is defined as tan inverse of y by x. Now tan theta, it is y by x, then theta is tan inverse of y by x. So for any complex number, we can define two things. We can find its modulus, which is r, and we can define its argument, that is this angle theta, and which is defined as tan inverse y by x. Now for this complex number, under root 3 plus iota, I can write its argument will be tan inverse 1 upon under root 3, and tan inverse 1 upon root 3 is simply pi by 6. So for this complex number, root 3 plus iota, the value of r is 2 and the value of theta is pi by 6. So if we look at this right angle triangle, then from here I can clearly say that x is r cos theta and y is simply r sin theta. So just by comparing x and y, we can find the value of r and we can find the value of theta. So this is another way of finding the modulus and argument of a complex number. Now, as we can write x as r cos theta and y as r sin theta, another way of writing this complex number z can be r cos theta plus iota r sin theta. So if I take this r common, I can write it as cos theta plus iota sin theta, and this is called as polar form of complex numbers. Now there is another formula that we generally use in complex numbers, and which is e to the power iota theta, and e to the power iota theta is cos theta plus iota sine theta. So this formula is called as Euler's formula. So we can get this result from elementary Maclaurin expansion. So if we consider the expansions for cos theta and sin theta and e to the power iota theta, then we can say that we can write cos theta plus iota sin theta as e to the power iota theta. So I can write any complex number z as r into e to the power iota theta, and this is called as Euler's form of complex number. So I'll take up an example. Now say for example, suppose the number is under root 3 plus iota, and I want to express this number in Euler's form. So if I have to express this number in Euler's form, I have to find its modulus and argument. So I can express this number as root 3 plus iota. Now this is root 3 and this is 1. This is theta and this is r. So from here I can say the value of r is under root of root 3 square plus 1, which is 2, and then 10 theta, it is 1 by root 3. Value of theta is pi by 6, and here we know that it is in first quadrant, so here the value of theta will be simply pi by 6. So once I have this r and theta, I can simply write this complex number z as r into e to the power iota theta, and r in this case is 2 and iota theta is pi by 6. So I can express this complex number root 3 plus iota as 2 into e to the power iota pi by 6.